Good morning, church family. I hope you're doing well today. It is Monday, May the 4th, and it is a sun is shining, and the beaches are open. Some restaurants are starting to open, and so I hope today that even though there's a lot of excitement in the air about opening up Florida, opening up Amelia Island and everything, I hope today you still are careful. There's still some social distancing things that you need to, you know, be aware of. So still be careful as you go out this morning and today as we start reopening up Amelia Island. So I love you. I miss you. Can't wait till we meet. I believe it's in 2 weeks on the 17th. And so it's going to be a fantastic day to finally get together and see each other and worship our King together. Today's passage comes out of Jeremiah chapter 17, and from verse 5 to verse 8. That's Jeremiah 17, verse 5 to verse 8. But I want to let you know this, that this will probably be the last week of doing these devotions. And so I'm going to do a little bit different. Some of the verses that I'm going to read will talk about fear not or being afraid or worrying, as you'll see today. But it's not going to say specifically, do not be afraid or fear not. What I want to do for this last week is I want to look at the verses that kind of have that theme, but not the exact phrase in it. And it kind of will, you'll understand why I think it's important for us to look at these verses this week as we're starting to, slowly get out of this quarantine season. So with that, I'm going to just start reading in Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 5. And I want you to notice that Jeremiah is describing two different, or actually the Lord here in this, Jeremiah's writing it, but the Lord is telling them to write about two different peoples. And if you'll listen to the two different people, and I hope and pray that you're in the second person, and that's where you are today. Let's pray. Let's read. This is what the Lord says. Cursed is the one who trusts in man, who draws strength from mere flesh, and whose heart turns away from the Lord. That person will be like a bush in the wasteland. They will not see prosperity when it comes. They will dwell in the parched places of the desert, but in a salt land where no one lives. But blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in Him. They will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when the heat comes. Its leaves are always green, and it has no worries in a year of drought, and never fails to bear fruit. So, in this second person that the Lord is describing here, the second person, it says, but blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord and who has confidence in Him. And my prayer today is that you are trusting in the Lord and you have confidence in Him. And I believe how we do that, how we place our confidence in Jesus, how we trust in the Lord, because He is always faithful. No matter what we're going through, no matter what season, no matter what's happening or circumstances, He is always faithful. There'll be times where it's a struggle for us and things are hard, but He is always faithful. And how we put our trust in the Lord, that's like it says in Romans chapter 12, I believe, where it says we're daily transforming our minds daily, renewing our minds daily. That's what it is. I think we have to daily get into His Word and be in His Word. So it says, blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord and whose confidence is in Him. They will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It will not fear when the heat comes, and it has no worries in the year of drought. So basically, it's whenever we trust in the Lord, we have confidence in Him, we will have no worries. When the drought comes, according to this tree, when the drought comes or when the heat comes, because we know that heat will come. We know that hard situations will come in life. We know that the drought is going to come. We know that in our own personal lives, things are going to happen. And during those times, if we have confidence in Him, if we trust in the Lord, we will be like that tree planted by the water, and we will have peace during those times. And my prayer is that today you have that peace, and that today you put your confidence in Him, and that today you put your trust in Jesus, and put your confidence in Jesus. No matter the pain you may be going through, or the situation, or the circumstance, no matter what's going on, my prayer is that today you get into His Word and start reading His Word. If you want a book to read, read the book of Philippians. It's a great book in the New Testament. It's an easy read, I think. And so just, I love you. I'm praying for you. Let's pray. God, I just pray for this day. God, I pray that today, as it says in this book of Jeremiah, in this chapter in Jeremiah, God, that we are able to put our trust in you. God, that we are put our confidence in you. And God, that we can lean into that confidence, we can lean into that trust, and we can rely on you, Father. Lord, even though our world around us may be crumbling and our heart may be broken or our situation may seem dire, God, that we put our trust in you. And Jesus, that way we can be ready for when hard things come. God, and that's my prayer for us, Lord. Lord, I love you. I thank you for this day. Thank you for the grace and mercy that comes through your Son, Jesus. And it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Church family, I love you. Can't wait to see you. Hope you have a great day. Remember to get into the truth of God's Word. And remember that in Christ Jesus, there is always hope. God bless.